Hello and welcome to today's video. Today we're going to go through the installation process of the Microsoft Center of Excellence kit. It's actually very straightforward. The Microsoft Center of Excellence kit is being updated every few months by Microsoft, and it's really important to keep it updated. So once first we're going to create an adequate environment. So it's very important to have the COE kit running in a specific environment created for the Center of Excellence, which should be a production environment and only accessible for the admins. And then once we have our environment set up, we're going to go ahead, download the COE kit from GitHub and install it. So first of all, the user should be a global tenant admin, Dynamics 365 service admin, or Microsoft Power Platform service admin. The user should also have a Power Apps per user license, a Power Automate license, and also the Power BI license. Also, the user you will use to install this will need access to an Office 365 mailbox that is REST API enabled. Yeah, if you want to share Power BI reports that the COE kit will generate, then you'll also need the Power BI license. So let's get started. We're here within our Power Apps, and we'll have to go to the admin center. So one of the questions I get a lot is, where should we install the COE kit? In my opinion, the COE kit should be installed in a separate environment. So it should be an environment solely dedicated to administration of the Power Platform. And this should also be a production environment. So we're going to go ahead and create a new environment. We're going to call it Center of Excellence. We're going to choose a group. Then the type should always be production. If you're working in a test tenant like I'm right now, you can also use developer. But if you're actually installing this for your organization, you should always use production environments. Then of course, we'll need a Dataverse data store. It's already locked here as yes. And then we'll click next. And if you employ it in your organization and you want to get an overview of the flows and apps you're having, you want to take control of your Power Platform, then you don't deploy the sample apps and data. But if you're like me, just doing it for testing and just as a tutorial, we can deploy sample apps and data. That way, our COE kit won't be empty when we install it. So now that we have our environment created, we need to set some settings within this environment. So we're going to click on the environment we're going to install the COE kit in, and we have to go to settings. Then click on product, features. And then on the right side, if you scroll down a bit, you find the Power Apps component framework for Canvas apps. And we have to set this to on, allow publishing of Canvas apps with code components. And once this is on, we can scroll down and click save. Because before we can install the COE kit, we do have to install the creator kit. So the creator kit has some components that the COE kit needs to function correctly. And to be able to use these components and install them, we do have to set this setting to on. So now that that's saved, we're going back to our solutions. Make sure you're in the Center of Excellence environment you just created. And then we can download the creator kit. We just look for creator kit in Google. Here we go, click on install the creator kit, and within here we will find the download link. So we download this package. It's not very big, so it should go quickly. And then we go back to solutions and click on import solutions, and we're going to look for our creator kit file. Click on open, next. Now there's nothing more to do, we just click on import. And this will import our creator kit solution. So once this is done, we can go ahead and import the Center of Excellence toolkit. Okay, so now that we have our environment ready, we will go to solutions and we will import the COE kit. Where can we find it now? So Microsoft publishes a new version of the COE kit every few months, and it's really important to keep it updated. And it's very easy to find. You just open a new tab, look for COE kits download, and then you can open the first page here, Starter Kit for Microsoft Power Platform, Center of Excellence, and you will see here the download button, which starts the download for you. And once you have it downloaded, you can open it on your desktop and open the folder. And you'll see there are a few elements within the COE kit downloaded. So we have a few Power BIs, we have some zip files, the Center of Excellence core components, the Center of Excellence innovation backlog, the nurture components, the admin task analysis. But the one that's really important for us now is the Center of Excellence core components. You'll see that's a managed solution. And we'll go back to our solutions, click on import solution, browse for this zip file, core components. We open it, we click on next. Now you'll see the details of what we're importing. So we are importing the Center of Excellence core components. Advanced settings is enable plugin steps and flows included in the solution. That's fine. We keep that checked. Click on next. So the next step for us is to create all these connections the COE kit needs to function correctly. So we need to be able to connect to Outlook, to Teams, to the Dataverse, Power Automate, and also the Power Platform for Admins connector, the Office 365 users connector, and so on. So in my case, these were all created automatically for me. So I can just check here if it's the right account. I only have one account, so that's fine. There's just one that wasn't created automatically, and we can do that manually. That's usually the HTTP with Azure AD connector. So we'll click here on invalid connection and just connect it manually. So the base resource URL and also the Microsoft Entra ID resource URI is basically this. So it's just the graph.microsoft.com URL. And if you use this, we don't need a data gateway. So we leave this unchecked. And then we click on sign in. Sign in with our user account. And that's that. So now we have this connection created. Let's see if it worked. Here it is. So now we click on next. In here, they want us to set some variables, but we are going to leave all of this empty and click on next. These values will later be set within the app when we set up the Center of Excellence. So let's just import this now. The setting up of the COE kit was actually a very tedious process in the past because it included, more than 50 flows, which you had to activate in a certain order. And if you messed up the order, it wouldn't work correctly. But now it's actually very easy because now there's an app to help it set up, and you just follow through the different screens of the app. So once the package imported successfully, we can see the little message here. And we can also see that there are still 31 environment variables that need to be updated. That's no reason to worry. That's normal. So we do still have to set a few variables, but we will do this with the help of the app that's within the solution. So you can find it in your solutions within managed or all. And you can see it here, the Center of Excellence core component. We're going to click on it. And just to go through a bit what's in there, what did we just import? So we have 15 different apps. Some of these apps are meant to be used independently, and some of these apps are actually embedded within the Power BIs, which is a really cool feature. We then have 110 cloud flows. So you can see now all of them are off, and we will go ahead and activate some of them. So most of them are actually inventory flows. So they just run through the environment, all of our environments, on a regular basis and take inventory of what we have. But some of those are actually flows that that we can set on activate later on, which could be, for example, the welcome email, where we welcome new users when they create their first flow or app. We do have cleanup helpers that delete solutions that are no longer within the environment and so on. We do have two Power BI dashboards within here as well. And we're just going to go ahead and start the setup process. And we're going to go back to solutions. Then on the left menu, we're going to click on apps. So within here, you can see all the apps that were installed within the Center of Excellence toolkit. And what we are going to do is open the COE setup and upgrade wizard. So we're going to click on play. So the first time we're opening this app, actually the first time we open any Power app, Microsoft asks us for our app permissions. So we need to give permission that these connections can be used with our account. We just make sure this is the right account here, which in my case it is, and we click on allow. So once the app opens, you can see the first screen is to confirm your prerequisites. As we stated at the beginning of the video, you need to have the specific rights and permissions as well as licenses to be able to access the full scope of the Center of Excellence toolkit. So you need to be service admin, global tenant admin, or Dynamics 365 service admin. It says here you have to verify manually, so please be sure that you have these rights, these permissions within your tenant. Then you absolutely need the Power Apps per user license and also the Power Automate per user license. In my case, it says fail because in this tenant, I don't have these licenses. In your case, it should definitely say success. If not, you should check your licensing. We click on next. And on the next screen, we have to configure our communication methods. So within the Power Platform, we know three different personas: the admin persona, the maker persona, and the user persona. The admin persona is surprisingly all the admins. Then the maker persona are actually users that are creating apps and flows and creating resources within the Power Platform. And the user persona is just users within the Power Platform. So somebody that has to access a Power app or a flow or whatever it is they want to access. So now we want to define how we want to communicate with these groups. And we click on Configure Group and then Add a Microsoft 365 group that we already created beforehand. Usually within an organization, we already have Azure AD security groups. So we will be able to select them here. I don't have these security groups created yet, so I will just use some of these already pre-configured groups. So for my admin persona, I will just say, okay, that's leadership, select group. For my maker persona, I will select the, let's say the contortion team. And then for our user persona, I will select all employees. If there's a group that I know I have created and I can't find it in a dropdown, I can always paste the Azure Active Directory ID of this group. That way I can find it here and I can add it to my user persona. I'm also, there's also the possibility to create a new group from here, but for now we will select the ones we already created. So select group and we'll click on next. The next screen is for some mandatory settings. It's already filled out. It's usually correct. So yes, our Power Platform is commercial. Our tenant ID was already pre-filled. The production environment is yes. So in your case, if you have it in a production environment, this should say yes. And then also an email address for an individual admin. So we have our admin group, our admin persona, but we also need one specific email because there are some processes, some flows, some automations that can't send communications to groups. So in this case, they need one specific individual's email, and that's my email here. So we click next. So within this screen, we want to configure our inventory data source. We do have two ways of going about our inventory. The classic way was the cloud flows. It's still the cloud flows. So we have different flows that search our tenant for all the flows, apps, everything we have, all the resources, all the inventory, and it creates a digital inventory within our center of excellence. The other way of doing it would be a data export. So we can export the data we have in our Power Platform and use it directly by filling into an Azure data lake storage and then having it in there. For now, we will do it the standard way, which is the cloud flows, and we click next. Now we have to run our three main setup flows. We just click on run, and every few minutes we can click on refresh. Those flows need to be run before going on with any further configurations because they set up the first part of our center of excellence. So now we have to run our inventory flows. These flows help us to recollect all the information we have within our tenant. And here is why we need the premium license. So these flows won't work if we don't have the Power Apps or Power Automate premium license. In this tenant, I don't have the premium license, so I can't turn them on. You can see it's not working. But if you have the premium license, you will be able to turn them on at this point, and you should. So you definitely have to turn on all of these manually. In this screen, we have the possibility to share these apps. So we have some admin apps we can share with our colleagues within our admin team. So once all the inventory flows have finished, and they might take a while, we will be able to see data within our dashboards. So we have to set up our dashboards. You will find these dashboards within the folder we downloaded before with the zip file of the Center of Excellence. And in there, we have to open the Power BI dashboard and configure it and then publish it. So for now, in here, we don't have to do anything. Just click on next. So these were the steps to successfully set up your Center of Excellence toolkit. So after setting up the basic configuration of the Center of Excellence toolkit, we can see here there are a lot of processes that we still have to configure in order to be able to use them. So there's the compliance process, the inactivity notifications process, the cleanup for orphaned resources. So those are resources that don't have any owners anymore, the team's environment governance, maker assessment, training in a day, and so on. So The Center of Excellence Toolkit really gives us a lot of different processes we can use, but first we have to configure them. So in this case, we do have to upload the other components we also downloaded in our folder. So there's the audit components and also the nurture components we would have to upload to be able to configure these processes. But this is something for a different video, and I hope you enjoyed setting up the Center of Excellence together with me, and have a good day.